Have you realized that it's been almost a full year since Chainsaw Man Part 1 ended? You remember that feeling of reading the final arc weekly? Denji, who seemed invincible at the time, so powerless in the face of Makima. It had me excited every chapter. Both sides laid everything they had out on the table, and we finally got to see the full extent of both Makima and Denji's powers. And not only that, but we also got plenty of heartfelt moments between different characters, which really made this arc. Fujimoto was really in his bag throughout the entire arc, and I was enjoying every last bit of it. And then, we ended with this final page. This final chapter, which seemingly was a closing act for the main antagonist Makima, yet also the beginning of a new story for Denji, left me with so many different feelings. And it irks me thinking about all the time that I had to go without any new Chainsaw Man content. Chainsaw Man used to be the backbone of the weekly Shonen Jump reads, and without it, each week feels kinda empty.
Especially since Shonen Jump doesn't know how to manage what series making into the weekly catalog.
And within these 10 months since Chainsaw Man has ended, I've had a lot of time to think about the potential that Part 2 really has. And honestly, I think in many ways it could be better than even Part 1, and that's really what I want to discuss in today's video. For starters, Part 1 and Chainsaw Man really focused on the raw amount of just control that Makima had over every aspect of Denji's life. I want to particularly talk about Denji right now and get to the other characters in a minute. Denji was very dead set on appealing to everything Makima wanted from start to finish. Whether it be him literally barking for Makima, or completely risking his life against opponents he didn't have much of a chance against because she just asked him to. And throughout the entire Part 1, Denji was fine with being someone else's puppet. While we had amazing character writing for him, I think a lot of the growth he could have experienced got cut short due to the whole idea of Part 1. And I think that going into Part 2 with Denji finally have a sense of his own self and his own desires, it could lead into a whole lot of new situations in which we get to see Denji make real decisions on his own and actually get to follow through with them. We saw hints of this when he literally asked Reese to run away with him, but we've never got to see this fully realized. And I think that Part 2, especially since Denji is seemingly playing a superhero-like role in society, will pave way for a bunch of new great moments furthering Denji's character without him being hindered by Makima. And not only Denji, but I think there's room for a whole new cast of characters who can also be explored in different ways and once again not have that development hindered. For example, we still have Kishibe, Kobeni the Queen, obviously, and a character that I'm very excited for, Hiromi Yoshida. I'm particularly excited for Yoshida because he was clearly a very skilled fighter, and we also know that he's also in high school around the same time that Part 1 was ending, so there's a very popular theory going around that Denji and Yoshida will end up in the same high school, which would be really cool to see. Yoshida could easily take place as one of the primary protagonists to play a similar like side role to Denji, like how Aki and Power did. And given that Part 2 has potential slice of life moments since Denji is going to be going to high school, there's bound to be a bunch of entertaining interactions that I'm really looking forward to. Like, we could easily see relationships being formed with Denji and other students. Like, that nigga might really pull himself a baddie, we might not never know. Or maybe we get insight on how Denji feels about making new relationships due to the events that happened in Part 1, so maybe he's really hesitant about it. Whatever it is, I'm sure Fujimoto will take advantage of this setting to develop other characters around Denji. We also already have an objective that could take up a decent portion of Part 2, being the hunt for Power. We know that Power sacrificed herself to give Denji a second chance, and I think that Denji is 100% going to be looking for her. And this objective could easily expand the world building, as we might get to take a trip into Hell, the birthplace of most devils. Fujimoto could easily get into his artistic bag and pull out some really trippy landscapes to go with the setting, which I'd really love to post on my IG. Go follow me on IG, by the way, at Aokiji. I got it linked in the description. And speaking of Hell, we have easily the most hyped part about Part 2 being the Primal Fears, which I suspect to be one of the main antagonists of Part 2. We got to see the Darkness Devil back in Part 1 dominate the main cast and even overpower the likes of Makima. Considering Denji isn't the same strength as Chainsaw Man, we don't have to be worrying about any stakes being lowered because of how strong Denji was. Whether it's a direct conflict against a Primal Fear, or maybe somebody makes another contract, they are bound to be involved in one way or another. They are easily the most exciting part of the Chainsaw Man lore, and I think that they do wonders for the world building of the series. Overall, I think Chainsaw Man Part 2 has potential to cover a lot of aspects of the story that Part 1 didn't really get to hit, and even expand topics already touched or hinted at. I truly don't know if Chainsaw Man Part 2 is coming out anytime soon, but if I had to guess, I'd assume it would be around the time that the anime drops or already during its run. That's obviously me assuming that Fujimoto wants to chase the bag, in which Part 2 will obviously sell the best when there's a beautiful anime adaptation running at the same time. Chainsaw Man is a really great series, but I do think that there are things holding it back from being an actual peak series, but I feel like those things could easily be covered in Part 2. Though if Chainsaw Man ended after part 1, I wouldn't be too pissed because part 1 ended pretty smoothly. I'm still expecting a part 2 soon. Let me know what you're most excited for when it comes to Chainsaw Man part 2. And if you enjoyed this video, please make sure you like, share, and subscribe because it means a lot to me. And alright, that's all from me. I will talk to y'all later.